further than their northern neighbor to remind people of the ecological and economic risks of oil tanker traffic. Years after the disastrous Exxon Valdez spill in Alaska, entire fish and wildlife populations and coastal communities have yet to recover. What's more, the navigation route of the Valdez through Prince William Sound was far less dangerous than the proposed Enbridge tanker route. By superimposing the impact area of the Exxon spill over BC's coast, one begins to get a sense of just what's at stake here. Its 2,200 kilometer length would cover virtually the entire BC coast.
If we had a tanker accident on the coast of British Columbia, it would literally wipe out all of our cultures, all of our salmon, all of our ground fish and halibut and cod and everything else. We cannot allow this to happen.
We're over 20 years since the Exxon Valdez disaster in Alaska, and they're still analyzing the impact. They're still finding crude oil in the beaches. The orca whales still have not returned, and economies and communities have been devastated by it.
The recent catastrophe still unfolding in the Gulf of Mexico from the blowout of BP's Deepwater Horizon oil well has also provided a potent reminder of the risks of introducing oil to sensitive coastlines. And Enbridge itself has given British Columbians even more cause for concern, following their own recent disaster in Michigan, where the company's pipeline spilled close to 4 million liters of oil, contaminating the Kalamazoo River and nearby residential community of Battle Creek. Adding insult to injury, the same company has had two other major pipeline leaks since then, in Illinois and near Buffalo, New York. The west coast of Canada is no stranger to environmental battles, but nothing so far compares to what's coming down the pipeline now. The resistance to the Enbridge proposal, led first and foremost by First Nations, is growing stronger by the day.
Enbridge had come into Hartney Bay and had a meeting there. You could feel when you're being patronized, you know, a little isolated community of 160 people. And so I told him, what you see here is not what you get. We're a clan system, we're First Nations, we have relatives all up and down this coast, and we're all coastal people and we depend on the sea. And whatever help we need, they're going to be there.
Everything is at stake here in this battle over the pipeline in BC's coast. Our international reputation, our constitution that protects Aboriginal title and rights, the democratic voice of the majority of British Columbians, and the last bastions of Canadian wilderness.